good morning or good afternoon or good evening. Hi, welcome again. I am going to make a flower painting, especially for someone special. I'm trying to recreate something that I already did on canvas. This one I will make on paper. It's a flower wreath, I don't know, bloemenkrans is what we say in Holland. And so I have already put some gristle on my paper, so that's good. And I think I have to maybe think about the center of the piece, so I will use something. It's just a lid of a plastic container, so, and I will put it in the middle during making the drips with my paint. So I think it is quite centered, so that's okay. And I will just put some white on my paper, because that will help blend all the colors. Always a bit nervous when I have to do a commission piece, because it's a commission piece actually. But yeah, paint is paint, and you know, you can always paint over it. It's just paint, let's say it like that. It's just paint, it's okay. So I think this will be more or less the shape, maybe a bit bigger. Or shall I go all the way through to the edges? I think so. Yep. And if you want to know how I mix my paint and how fluid I make my paint, there is a tutorial on that short video to help you on your way and start creating beautiful things. And you can always add more white, of course. Good. Let's see, because I already pre-mixed my paints and I put them in these little containers with a lid on it, because I think I need a bit more water. Using this beautiful turquoise blue, it's one of my favorites, and I think I will add a bit lighter turquoise to this painting. I think more sky blue. See, I think it will be nice. And you know, I don't have a plan. Yeah, I know what I'm doing, but I don't have a plan like how it should look like. I just, you know, start, and it's nice to have surprises, right? I like surprises, especially the surprises of life. There you go. It's the blue. I think that will be enough for now. And I always, in most of my paintings, I use this beautiful purple. It's violet, permanent violet blue, blue violet, I don't know. And it goes with every color. It's really such a easy color. And it just does it. It just works. And it's also nice to have a bit of contrast. And today I will think I will put in a bit of pink. It's a Venetian pink. Oh, by the way, all my colors, all my paints are Amsterdam paints, so just yellow, golden yellow, goes really, really good with the permanent violets. And I think I can take away this thing. And there you go. This is the first setup of my all my colors, so yeah. I think we will start with working and creating flowers. So, okay, let's start with this balloon that you just tap. I forgot my kitchen towels, so I have to get my kitchen towels. Because the reason why I use kitchen towels, or why my balloon, even though there is still paint on there, I do that so I can keep my colors really bright, not smudgy. Sometimes I will do one or two, but then so you just make, you know, your what you like, your pattern, your composition. And actually I realized this is the first time that I create a floral wreath on paper. I created flowers on paper, but not a flower wreath, so, or wreath. I don't know. Is it wreath or wreath? I don't know. Well, you know what I mean. Hopefully. There you go. I think I need more white. Yep, definitely. So it's a tryout for me too, to see how this works on paper. Stay where you are, blijf op je plek. Okay, so I will put in more white, and your paper will go a bit bubbly, wobbly. I tape my paper down, but that's not necessary. I just do it because I know it will stay in place, and just to be sure. But I've done floral paintings without taping my paper down, so it's not necessary. For the process again. And you can turn your balloon, like, you know, roll it. It's okay. Just try it out, and if you don't like some parts, then you just put more paint on there Okay. Let's see. It's always, or at least for me, it's always good to, you know, step back, get a cup of coffee or a cup of tea, come back and see if you like what you see. I think I can go bigger. Yeah. And for those who are, well, if you're watching, thank you so much for watching my videos. I'm trying to put at least two videos on my YouTube channel. But yeah, sometimes I'm too busy. You are here for the first time, welcome. Thank you so much for watching. And if you like my work and like seeing how I do my paintings, feel free to subscribe, of course. If you have any questions, put them in the comments below. And please share these videos with your friends, or give me a thumbs up. Like, I really appreciate that, and really appreciate you watching. Yeah, and I always forget to introduce myself. So my name is Wendy. And I live in Holland, in the Netherlands, south part of the Netherlands. And all my work that you see is for sale if you want to buy something, or you are interested and I can make you something like this piece. I'm making that specially for someone. And actually, it's pretty funny. Well, I find it really funny, because of the internet, that you go straight away. I went international with selling my art pieces. So this one goes, if she likes it, goes to the Philippines, and I'm so happy. I also sold some work to an American. So my pieces are going all over the world, and I really like that, because if you want to create beauty, right, it's no fun having them all by yourself. People need to enjoy them, so I'm really happy that they go all over the world. Sold, of course, in Europe too, but yeah, love it. Really proud of the pieces that go and have their home somewhere else in the world. Isn't that funny? I find that funny. I think I need to adjust the shape a bit, because here I'm losing my shape. So and as said, if you have any questions, just let me know. Put them in the comments below, or you can send me an email. And maybe you have like requests, or you want me to show something, let me know. I love doing this, so sharing my experiences. I love watching other people on YouTube doing their artwork. I really like that. think if I put it with purple, that will give a really, really nice color combination. So, okay. And start over again. Just tapping down your balloon, creating all these beautiful. Well, in the beginning, maybe they don't look like flowers, but wait and see. You will see that these flowers just arise. So, and enjoy the process. That's the most important thing. I'm so sorry. Well, I have to I have to do something about this video. That's my friend, she calls, and she's a lovely lady. I would love to talk to her, but right now I'm in the middle of creating my painting. Balloon went walkabout. And I'm working on special paper. This is actually very, very nice paper. I went to a little shop here in the neighborhood, here in this part of Holland. And there was a very knowledgeable old man. And he said, did you try this paper? It's with a linen look. Linen, I don't know if linen is a Dutch word, an English word, I don't know. But it has a bit of... I'm looking for words right now. How do you call that? I don't know. You know, that you can see that there is something in there. And he said, did you try this one? I said, no. He said, you should try it. It's really good paper and it can carry a lot of paint. So I said, okay, I'll try that. That's really kind of you to give me these tips. You can learn a lot from people who are in the business for a long time, right? So, and I'm really grateful because it works. It really works. And the reason why I'm creating this on paper is because of the shipments. Because this lady lives in the Philippines and it's easier to ship, right? And cheaper, of course, because, yeah. In this part of Holland, we always have a lot of tourists. We are very known. It's beautiful. Part of Holland, and I live on an island that's called island. It's connected to the mainland with bridges, of course, but not until the 1960s it was an island. And a lot of people come here because of the ocean, the North Sea, because of all the water that we have. And I live in a part that's called Noord-Beveland, and it's always so quiet. It's the second next less populated part of Holland. Now, if you know, Holland is not big, or the Netherlands is not a very big country, right? And we live here with almost 17 million people. So in comparison to, for instance, Ireland. Ireland has 3 or 4 million people, and Ireland is bigger than Holland. So, yeah, can you imagine? I live in this part of the Netherlands. That's, I think, on the island we have 7,000 inhabitants in the summertime. It's way, way more, yeah. And of course it's good for tourism to come here. That's good for business, but yeah, at some points I always think, gosh, it's a bit too crowded in the summer times. But yeah, there you go. Okay, I think, yeah, I will leave it for just a bit and come back and maybe do a bit more magic. We'll see. Even if your paint is getting a bit dry, just put some white on there or another color. And you will make a bit more layers. Just take it easy. see if I can. And if you want to just put at some place a bit of your paint, just put it on your balloon and see what it does. It will look like you have a really big block of white paint, but you will see it will dry really nice and flat. Okay, so I tried and added some of this beautiful bright green, and actually it works with the yellow and the purple and the blues. And when I tried it, I can't stop myself, I have to continue. So sorry for this part that you didn't see, but I will show you that part, and it's just like small drops. And if you want to go a bit more into the center of it, you just put on the white drops and use that as your base to create the flowers. And I think it really looks nice with this green. I'm really happy with the results. And don't care about, you know, it's like a green spot right now, but just continue using that paint, and lightly touch your paper, and you'll be okay. Somebody said in one of my other paintings, she said, I have the feeling that I have to look for the clover, the four clovers, Klavertje vier, in Holland, I think all over the world. If you find a clover with four leaves and it brings happiness, Klavertje vier. So that was funny. Didn't think about that, but yeah, I can imagine why she would say that. There you go, you just blend. Actually, you're blending your paint into the paint that is already there with your balloon. Just tap it, see if you like it, and continue. Yeah. And I think it brings it all together. All the colors come together because of this green color, and I'm really happy with that. a really big blob of green. I'm not happy with that. Can you see it? This one. So you just move the paint around. And there. Now another thing, and I use this tool. You will see people with dot art using this, and it's actually something of a tool that they use with nail art. So to, you know, paint your nails. And I'm using it to, well, do a lot of fun stuff. So one of the things that I like to do is just make some swirls. And can use also paint, of course, and I think I will go for the dark blue. Let's see if I have to stir that first. That's okay. Good. And I just dip it in there and place it somewhere, and you will have something. And these details, I think, make your painting, or for me it does actually. It makes it like all tiny things are going on. And I just sometimes, I have to sit down, just make some dots. It will bring your painting to life. You can put in details in certain flowers if you want to. Yeah. Just go around having fun, just, you know, relax. And it gives you a chance to, when you do this detailed stuff to just look around and find the flowers you've created. Like, oh wow, that's beautiful. And then you bring the attention to that by placing some of these dots. I'm using a dark color, but you can of course use a light color if you want to. Yeah. I hope that I have the good light to show you the colors, because the blues that you can see, like these ones here, they are a bit more brighter. They always turn out a bit grayish, but they are actually a really bright turquoise color. Let me just give you the full view. There you go. And then going for the details. And the yellow is a bit brighter than on this. I'm happy with the results. Beautiful colors, beautiful flowers, all kinds of stuff is going on. Yeah, I'm always still amazed by how the paint shows itself. Okay, now that's it. I hope you enjoyed it. Any questions, put them in the comments below. Give a like if you really like watching me creating these art pieces. Share with friends my videos, please do that. and hope to see you next time. Okay, bye bye. Thank you for watching. Bye.